I went from one of the worst golfers you've ever seen in your life to a single-digit handicap in less than 1 year. This round is going to be a tough one. At my local country club, we set the tough task of breaking 40 today. And trust me, you don't want to miss it. This one has all the bells and whistles for what makes it being a very challenging round. Let's go.
Doing?
Ugh,
you are an idiot. What the hell are you doing, Pop?
Starting things off a little bit on the confusing note, we're at hole number 4. A little busy on the first couple holes. Super scary tee shot here. A lot of trees along the left-hand side. Gonna try to hug them. Gonna play a little bit of a cut that I've been working with as of late. Got 5 iron in hand. Really just a nice baby butter cut. Should be perfect here. All right, didn't catch it perfect, but we are technically in the middle of the fairway, and we like that. Gonna have a little longer in than we want, though.
All right, tee shot was a little bit of a toe banger, but totally gonna work nonetheless. Fellow member here at Chevy Chase Country Club, that's what we're playing today, by the way, is just ahead of me. I let him play through. I'm gonna be recording. I wanna be chilling out here today. It's a beautiful day in sunny California, 80 degrees or 78 degrees, something like that. We'll take that all freaking day, baby. Anyways, gonna have a little bit longer than I wanted, but an absolutely clear shot at the hole, which we love. Blue pin means it's gonna be slightly back. Let's see if we can't take advantage of it.
All right, after letting that gentleman play through, we have about 153, 154 adjusted. This can be exactly my 9 number, but because it's a blue flag, I kind of want the ball to land and roll back a little bit, so it's not gonna really happen. It's probably gonna check up a little bit with the 9 iron. So I'm gonna kind of play of a chippy cut 8. So it should stop a little bit, but just roll out just a tad. That's it. So our ball cut so much, it cut all the way to the right. That's not good. So ended up being the perfect number. We are literally exactly pin high. The only problem is I have quite the crazy shot coming up next. Access behind the ball is not great. A little bit of a hard pan, and it just goes straight into a bunker up there. This is a weird one. It's like, how do you play this shot, honestly? That was pretty awesome. Okay, let's go. It's pretty decent. We're gonna talk about it on a different video, but there is a new putter in the bag from the last time you guys saw. Ended up just skirting off the first cut here. It's totally fine. Better than I could have hoped for, to be fair. Looks like it's slightly downhill and breaking a hair from my left to right. It's about 18 feet, probably playing like 12 to 14. I think it's actually breaking right to left. It's not breaking left to right. Okay, so we leave ourselves in quite some trouble here on our next shot. Ended up lipping out just on the right, but it's never gonna really settle. The pace was a little too hard. To be fair, looks like it's fairly straight uphill, maybe a bit breaking left to right for me now. Oof, hit my spot, honestly. Just didn't break at all. Took a couple of bounces. Double bogey in the first is not great, but it is what it is. Hole number 5 is a very tough par 3. Nearly 200 yards. We have quite the distance to go. Bit of a tricky green as well, to be honest. Point of reference here is that we do have a front flag. It's probably playing like 180, 187 to that front flag and about 194 to the middle. I'm going to aim for the middle here and just trust that we get up there. Going to tee my ball up just a hair. Be the club. Be the club. All right. Beautiful shot. Cut perfectly, landed soft with a 5 iron, and we have probably 20 feet for birdie. Feels good to hit a really good shot with the long iron on a really tough par 3. Look at where this ball pitched. Incredible. Lands soft as can be. I mean, that is sick. With the 5 iron, to land just right here and up over there, let's go. Little tough to pick it up on the camera, but what a tricky putt we left ourselves with here. So 27 feet between me and a birdie, but it's gonna be playing much shorter. Oh wow, this is kind of a double breaker. Die, die, die. Honestly, that felt like a really good putt. Clean up for par on tough hole. That was a nice par.
That was definitely one of the tougher holes, and to get away there with the par feels pretty damn good. So, gonna let another player go right through. We'll wait here patiently and get to the next hole. Two over, through two.
Big bounce back on the last hole. Now we have another pretty reasonably easy par three. Only trouble is the wind has completely picked up and it's right behind me. It's 110 to the pin. Haven't been feeling too comfortable with my yardages and I don't think my sand wedge can get there. It's just like a chippy. I think that's just it. Like slightly choked up. Sit a bit. Okay, got a little lucky. Caught it a bit thin, even though I teed the thing up. But we're just off the right, should be okay.
These Break 40 videos have been a ton of fun, and I've really been appreciating you guys for the constant support on these videos. Yeah, this is actually the country club that I'm a member at. I don't know if I've actually made a video here yet, but the Bob Does Sports guys used to actually be members here, and they used to come film here, which is pretty cool. But anyways, we have a chip and a putt to give ourselves a shot here at another par to get up and down from. A little bit of a tricky lie is what it looks like from here situation, but shouldn't be too difficult because we're positive. Be positive.
So it's about 33 feet to the pin. It's about 11 feet to cover the fringe and then about 20 yards of rollout. Green is sloping slightly down and left away from me. I think the best shot here is just to get it on the green somewhere to the right side of the hole and let it trickle down, and that'll give us our best bet here. Lie is pretty deece, pretty deece. Settle. Ooh, just had it come out way too low and just never was gonna have a chance to stop. Okay, boys and girls, got a tough hole here. I'm gonna try to get a read situation. Okay, 15 feet. Breaking left to right the entire way, uphill, not going to be dripping it in there. I'm going to try to stay pretty aggressive, get the ball to the hole, worry about the rest when we get there. That was a good putt. Unfortunate bogey, pretty easy up and down, and we made it harder than it needed to be. But really happy with that putt there. 15 feet, we gave it a chance. A little more speed, it was good. But even then, just burn the front edge, just kind of snapped across at the end.
If you guys are new, if you're new to the channel, make sure to click the like, comment, and subscribe button. Videos like this are coming out twice a week right now, every Tuesday and Friday at 8:30 Pacific Standard Time. We're dropping, 8:30 a.m. I should say, we're dropping a brand new video every single week, twice a week. So there's a lot to look forward to on this channel. Cute run rain of golfs. If you want to see things that are relatable, if you want to see somebody through their journey of getting from a dog water golfer to something a little more, I guess, reasonable, this is the exact channel for you. We're gonna have a bunch of great coaches on here as well as a bunch of pretty decent golf moving forward. Anyways, we have another hole. Let me give you the information on that hole. This is hole number 7, and we are going to have to slightly lay up here. It is a very treacherous, very short though, 331 yard hole. Need about 210-ish off this tee shot. Probably gonna use 3 or 4 hybrid and just kind of just really ease it down there. It's what I'm thinking right now.
Okay, so 4 hybrid in hand, play a little bit of a cut. It really thins up down there around 210-ish yards. So just gonna really baby one down there, super smooth, OB left. Actually, it's not even OB, they're all red stakes, so it's just hazards left. That is gonna be so much fun to watch back on film. That did not go very far, but that was pretty. That was pretty to look at. All right, so the flag is about right here, which is covered, and it's also OB. If the flag is here, it's all OB along that right line. So not a lot of greatness. It's a blue flag, kind of baby down a little too soft. One, first off, we hit a freaking a stinger, and second off, it cut 40 yards. So we have a back pin about 140. I think it's gonna be like 135 to the front edge. There will be a bunch of bunkers protecting that left ridge, the left side of the hole. And on the right side of the hole, I think it's just all OB. So just gonna play a cut up there. with the 9-iron. Should get there most of the way at least. And just give it a nice swing. I think we just bounced into that first, not an awful shot, but kind of a scared shot.
Shot there, good contact, but clearly I just kind of was really scared about going OB right. And I just kind of pulled it a little further left. The start line was a little too far left. And I was just too stubborn or scared, I guess, to commit to the full shot. Ended up just falling short of the green and then rolling into the bunker. But anyways, got to get up and down once again to save par.
All right, so we ended up in the second bunker. I was mistaken, not the first one. Sand's a little bit on the interesting side. Our lie's pretty decent. Slightly downhill. Quite the situation here, boys and girls. That might be like the best shot of my life. Holy crap. That was insane. Okay, got... I mean, this is incredible that I'm even this close. That was a crazy lie in the bunker. I think it's breaking just a hair left to right, was what I'm initially seeing right now. Or right to left, I should say. This is a very makeable putt, honestly. Breaking just a hair right to left. I don't want to give up the hole here. I'm just going to aim it just literally right edge. Get into the hole, you freaking pansy. Ugh. God, we did all the hard work just to do that. What are you doing, pal? What are you doing? So it says that pin is like 100 yards away, but I mean, that's adjusted, of course. But the wind's definitely into, so it's probably playing like 107. Wind is almost 10 miles an hour of wind, probably. To be honest, I just kind of want to see what I could do with this guy. This is my sand wedge. But... I'm completely lost. Oh, we find ourselves in quite the situation. Pitch just back here. Stopped a little bit after that. Ended up 20 yards past this thing. That was awesome. One hop and one drop. Holy crap, let's make a putt. So it's about 7 or 8 feet. Again, slightly uphill, but let's make it. I see it slightly going left to right, just a hair, about like 1%-ish going left to right. It's like literally just off the left edge. Smashed it. Didn't even give it a chance to break. It's a little frustrating. How do I par the toughest par three, the 200-yard par three, and then... two other par threes that combine for 200 yards, so 100 each. I get bogeys. All right, we got a four hybrid once again. Just gonna play a nice cut. Just try to get about 200 yards. This is a 310-yard hole. Don't need the ball to go very far, honestly. Bounce left. That was weird. Off balance, not a great strike. I guess not the worst shot ever. Took a pretty friendly bounce left. So it's 128 playing down to like 118. 128 playing down to 118. Phone saying something completely different. Okay, I'm gonna trust what the rangefinder's telling me about 118. Should be just a full one of these, I think. I don't know how far anything goes now. Everything's just going further than I thought. Cut a little bit. Get past. Or just, I don't know how far anything goes. God damn it. Okay, pretty decent lie. Got a pretty decent amount of stuff to work with. Yeah, shouldn't really be that hard to get up and down from here. I mean, that's pretty good, guys. I can't even lie to you. Bunker play has been outstanding today. Really has been. I mean, on a downslope, I got that thing to stop. Another big putt to save... par. I have a little bit of good news. The par score here is actually 34. So by that math, it's actually a par 68 here, par 34 for the front nine. which means, ladies and gentlemen, we're still alive to hit our goal. I think we're 4 or 5 over, have a couple of strokes to play with, and it starts with hitting this one. This first one's going to be big. Tricky, tricky putt. I actually don't know which way this one's breaking. I don't have a clear vibe. I'm just going to trust it like right center. Hopefully I get lucky. I just don't have a read on it. What the hell was that putt? Turn the camera on and I forget how to putt, I guess. Another bogey that we didn't need. Okay, so here we are on hole number one, which is actually our, I think, 6th or 7th hole of the day. We have 2 par 5s in a row, and they're both pretty short. This is a super skinny fairway, as you can see. And that's how you hit that shot. There we go. Middle of the fairway. What a ball. All right, I think we have about it's like about 200 to the pin. Adjusted, it's about 215. Huge uphill slope. There is a false front up there and a bunker to the left. I'm gonna aim it to that bunker just off to the left. Gonna hit a nice baby fade in there. Oh man, that's a pretty shot, but it's a stinger. Run. Okay. Not how we drew it up, but let's chip and make a putt for a birdie. Not a bad spot to leave it. Hit a stinger on accident. We have about 32 yards to the pin. The first 20 yards are probably till we get to the green, and then the green has a little bit of rollout. So stock 20 yard pitch. It's a little annoying. I landed right into that freaking downhill slope and it killed it. I mean, that's almost funny. The ball landed. I had backspin on that somehow. Another tough spot with another tough putt for birdie, but I am happy to be putting uphill. This hole's a disaster. It's one of my least favorite green complexes on the course, mostly because it's just a tough. It's nothing wrong with the green. 2 putt pars, honestly, are gonna be really solid. It's gonna be swinging super hard left, right the whole time. It's about like 31 feet, probably playing like 36. Sit. What am I doing? Oh, you are an idiot. What the hell are you doing, Pop? Now we have a slider on the way back, just outside of the right. Just all about pace on this one. Oh my God. I mean, I barely tapped that ball. Bogey on that good of a tee shot feels really dumb. Just have not brought the best of it today. Okay, so here's hole number 2, another par 5. For what it's worth, another fairly easy one. It's tricky because you have to get the ball about 240 down to that little first cut. And then from there, it's a complete 90 degree turn to the right. Only way you have an open shot going for this green in 2. Otherwise, you have to lay up. And the most you can lay up to is leaving yourself still anywhere from pitching wedge to 8 iron on the way out. So you can never leave yourself short. Gonna need this 2 hybrid to do its job. Let's hit a nice cut along this tree line on the left. I think that's perfect. That looked and felt perfect. It just, hopefully it is. Once again, this is why this course is so tricky. Flag is right here, completely covered by all this nonsense. It is a front right pin. Tough to attack here with this current shot, and this is one of the best tee shots I've ever hit off that. Yeah, this is gonna really accentuate my cut here. So I'm gonna start this nice out to the left. It's 138 to the pin, but I honestly just wanna get to the middle of the green, so about 145 would be great. Feeling really good about this shot here. First eagle of our life on camera. I'm down. Oh my God, that has a chance. Go. Oh, I just scooped it. Just short. Not a bad spot to be, I don't think.
As it currently stands, if we par out, assuming the best here, and you can't even do that, honestly, with how we've been playing, we're unfortunately going to fall just shy of our goal by 1 stroke. So it'd be nice to birdie this one to give ourselves a little bit of hope going to the last par 3. But for now, it's just about getting up there and taking care of business. The short chip, we're short-sighted from the green. See what we can do.
Once again, leaving ourselves slightly short-sighted. Gonna walk this one off though. So it's about 24 feet and about 10 feet on. So gonna need to really fly it there. Just dropped dead on me. Oh! Honestly, not a bad birdie putt situation here. All right, we gotta get out of here with the par. At least promise myself that. I don't wanna be playing bogey golf today. Okay, breaks a little left to right for my putt. It's about 11 feet exactly. Slightly left to right. Come on, let's make a putt. Just get to the hole. Yes! That's a birdie. Holy crap, what a putt that was. Just died it right into the hole. We'll take a birdie. Oh, that feels good. So we have found ourselves in one of the last, or the literally the last, so there's no one of the last. Ending off on a par three for all the marbles. If we score ourselves a little bird ski here, we end up with a 39, breaking our goal and giving ourselves a chance at greatness. If we don't, then, you know, the world doesn't end, but we come out here and do this all over again next time. I haven't hit too many great shots today, and I would really love to finish today off with a nice one. 115 to the pin adjusted, slightly into us breathe. Gonna knock down this beautiful gap wedge, and it should just be the perfect number. I'm just mostly trying to speed into existence at this point because everything has not been the right distance. It's gonna give it a really nice whack, compressoration, and just should be perfect. Caught it a little chunky. Be a chunk flyer. Oh. Landed just on the green and then it rolled off. But it's still makeable. It's still makeable. All right, ton of green to work with here. It's about 45 feet total. I feel like surprisingly good about this. Great lie here. Sit. Ooh. Wow, really not bad. That really bit it nice and hard. Should have an easy cleanup for par. Okay, looks like it's just gonna be about left lip-ish. Little lefty lipitus, lefertus lipitus. That was a pretty daggum good chip. Honestly, flew it most of the way here and it stopped pretty fast. We'll take a par. Landed right on the number. Didn't break 40, but we scored 40, and we'll take that. Really, really not bad. Once again, a major thank you to everyone that came out to support today's video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and get excited for some lovely content from Japan. Until next time, it's Kieran, and I'm out. I think I'm out. Don't really have much more to say. Not a bad round. It was kind of bad, but we made up for it.